Welcome back to AM Live. I'm here with one of my favorite people, Beverly Houston-Fisher, and I want to thank you so much for all the work that you do for the veterans. It's very, very important. And Bev does a lot of work with the Project Thank You, which I think is very, very important. And tell our viewers about that.
Well, Project Thank You is a service we've actually been in operation since 2008. And we've been sending care packages overseas, serving over 12,000 soldiers so far. And now, in July of last year, we started bringing in and started our new program of outdoor adventures and nature-based activities.
Great.
To help them reintegrate. So we're sending them goodies while they're there and then trying to help them come back.
How wonderful.
In a nature-based way for families and, you know, current vets and our current military veterans and their families.
Well, I was emailing Donna. And I keep wanting to call her Donna Lyons, and it's Donna McLennan now. And she's back with the Colonel. They're in Washington, and we miss her dearly.
Right.
But she's a big veterans advocate, as well as she and I are both into Wounded Warrior Project. And she said to me, she goes, you know, people just don't understand how important it is
right.
that we support our veterans. And I said, you know, there are people, some people out there that just, they don't get it.
Right.
And now with this news in the forefront of what has been going on, I hope that it enlightens people and opens their mind to basically what they've been going through.
Right.
They've given to their country. It's time that the country gives to them. And not on a list at the bottom of the list, number one on the top of the list.
Right. Well, because, I mean, look at the suicide rate. A veteran is killing themselves every 65 minutes right now.
Yeah, that's uncalled.
And that's because they're not getting the attention they need, or it's because they're invisible scars. People don't really see what's going on in their
right.
mind and how they're
right.
not able to just function. You know, they're running around in survival mode.
Yeah.
And as you're running around in survival mode, you're just trying to literally survive from one thing to the other. You're never really grounded. You're never touching the earth and in the present.
Right.
And so that's why we do what we do. We have our resource library giving them some different perspectives on how to take the armor off. I mean, they're taught how to keep the armor on or put it on, but not
sure.
how to release it.
And you would think that after Vietnam, we would understand on how to treat your veterans, how not to treat your veterans. You think that we would have learned our lesson, but it just seems like the hits keep on coming when we talk about the military. And I don't get it. I just don't get it when these things happen.
Right. I think what it comes down to is community is going to have to be the answer for the veterans, not necessarily the government. The government is run as a machine
right.
more than as a personally, that's my opinion.
Yeah. No,
and so
I
they lose
you.
Track of the individuals and the people that are putting themselves forward for us to be ran like a machine.
Right.
So we're going to have to be the ones that are saying, we love you. You know, my dad was in Vietnam. My grandfather was in the war. My husband was in Desert Storm. So it is really close to me in my heart.
Right.
And they need to know that we care about them, that there are different places they can go to help. Get help, that they don't have to feel alone. Many people are going through this. You know, we have 22 million veterans and 49 million people that are married to or related to or supporting
and
those veterans.
That's the silent victim, mm-hmm. is the wives and children. People don't realize
right.
what they go through because they're all excited when their spouse comes back, and then they're faced with these bumps on the road sometimes, and it's like, why
right.
us?
Right. Well, did you have a chance on PBS the other night? There was Coming Back with Wes Moore, and he's a veteran. He had lost a couple buddies and one of his close friends to suicide and didn't understand why. So now he's going out and interviewing different veterans, current military and people that are out,
mm-hmm.
to see how they transition. Why is it easier for some to step back into a role here and why it's not for others. And what I noticed about so far is that most of the ones that are coming back and just stepping right in are going straight into emergency roles, whether it's police, suicide hotline is two of the people that they're showing, you know, and paramedics and people like that, because then they can keep that adrenaline going.
Right.
They've become adrenaline junkies whether they realized it or not.
Sure. And there's also a sort of a letdown when you come home and it's like, now what do I do? You know, when I'm used to doing, when I'm used to dodging bullets, I'm used to doing this, I'm used to doing that, I'm used to having strategies and setting forth policies and doing these different things, and these are the perfect people to put in those roles because they can think on their feet fast.
Right.
And they not only need that, we need them, because they're doing a great job.
We do. And, you know, you got to think, they're in a group of other military people. They were all running the same schedule. They were tight-knit. There was a tight bond. And then they come back, and they might be coming back to a family, which is wonderful, but they still don't know where they even fit in that family. And the family doesn't know how.
Right.
To fit them in, too.
It's tough, because I know when my grandparents came from Italy, all four of them, my mother's parents and my father's parents, and on my father's side, they already had two children in Italy, and they came over to the United States, and the first thing that they did is become American citizens, and out of the six children that they had, four of them, two girls, two boys, were all in the military.
Wow.
Three Navy, one was my father, and my aunt and my uncle, and then my other aunt was Army.
Wow.
So they were very, very proud of them.
Absolutely.
And it was amazing, because in those days you very seldom heard that women were in the military, but both of them were. One of them was a MASH nurse.
Wow.
The one in the Army.
She saw some
things, and it was really cute, because I've told this story before, but she was over in, they had incoming, and she ran into this guy and he knocked her down, and he turned around, he picked her up, he said, "I'm sorry, little lady." And it was Clark Gable. He was over there.
Poor baby.
He was over there, and she goes, "Clark Gable literally knocked me off my feet." It was really cute. But, Bev, I want you to tell people, if they want to help out in Project Thank You, what can they do and how can they get a hold of anyone?
We have a couple of different programs. We have our Hero Box program, which is, we have a couple locations, Subaru Plus and Mace Meadow Event Center. They both have the boxes.
Great.
So you get a box, it has a list, some cards, there's items on there, you fill the box, and then you take it back to either location, and then we ship it out for
them. And the Mace Meadows location
Event Center.
Okay, and that's located where?
Right there, Mace Meadow Golf Course.
At the golf course?
Yeah.
It's
actually a Mace Meadow Event Center. They have a huge room and everything.
Oh, okay. I know what you're talking
about.
And
that's where I teach my yoga on Thursday. It's free to veterans and their families.
Okay, great.
And that's every Thursday.
And is there a number that anybody can reach anyone at?
Yes. 245-6088 is local. 800-690-0896 is the 800 number.
Great.
Or our website is projectthankyou.org. Great.
Thank you for all your hard work and thinking of our veterans. And
thanks
your hubby.
Thanks for having me back.
And your family for serving. We got to go, and we're going to go over to Cam.